नमस्कार, मेरा नाम आशुतोष बहुगुणा है। मैं सर्टिन मैं एज ए साइंटिस्ट डी कार्यरत हूँ। आज हम साइबर सिक्योरिटी इनिशिएटिव्स इन इंडिया विषय पर चर्चा करेंगे। सो टुडे वी हैव अ लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन दिस सेशन अबाउट द साइबर सिक्योरिटी इनिशिएटिव्स इन इंडिया। वी विल डिस्कस द रोल ऑफ इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पॉन्स टीम। वी विल सी द इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी एजुकेशन एंड अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम इनिशिएटेड बाई द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। यू मे बी अवेयर अबाउट द डिजिटल इंडिया प्रोग्राम। सो डिजिटल इंडिया प्रोग्राम इज लॉन्च बाई द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया विद अ विजन विच इज सेंटर्ड ऑन अ थ्री की एरियाज दैट अ डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एज ए यूटिलिटी टू एवरी सिटीजन। एवरी सिटीजन शुड हैव एक्सेस टू द डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर। अनदर इज द गवर्नमेंट एंड सर्विसेज ऑन डिमांड ओवर द ICT नेटवर्क टू बी प्रोवाइडेड। एंड थर्ड इज द इम्पावरमेंट ऑफ द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया। सो डिजिटल इम्पावरमेंट ऑफ द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया। सो दीज आर द थ्री की एरियाज ऑन विच द विजन ऑफ डिजिटल इंडिया इज सेंटर्ड। सो द की कंसर्न अबाउट इज द साइबर सिक्योरिटी। सो साइबर सिक्योरिटी द ICT इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर and the services and the digital growth, what we have to do is the manage the cyber security concerns which arise from the cyber security threats and cyber security malicious actors. So first, like we will see in a cyber security concerns, that expanding role and implementation of technology across sector in the country. So today we are relying more and more on the ICT infrastructure, and so our attack surface also increased. Second is the volume and complexity of information technology ecosystem in the country. Third is the growth in volume of transactions and sensitive data exchange. So rapidly changing security and threat landscape. As we know, on the daily basis, there are new threats, new malware, new viruses are emerging, and those are the threats to the cyber infrastructure. So there is a shift in attack vectors and the nature of their launch. So today attackers are able to remotely conduct the attack on the ICT critical infrastructure and ICT infrastructure and services. So to reduce the cyber security risk exposure of IT infrastructure and ecosystem in the country, that's the objective and that's the concerns for the governments, organizations and sector across the world. So in India, if you see the top level national document is the National Cyber Security Policy, which is a guiding document, which provide a guiding document how we should secure our country's cyber ecosystem. This cyber security policy facilitates creation of secure computing environment. This provide the guide to stakeholders' actions, what they need to do. It provides a roadmap and articulates our strategy, how we have to protect our cyber security ecosystem of the country. In the policy, the implementation of policy is by the means of actions by the government, actions in the collaboration of PPP model, action by the private sector, and the academia. So National Cyber Security Policy is the top level document of a country, and it's available at the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology website, that's www.meti.gov.in. Another document created by CERTIN is the Cyber Crisis Management Plan, and this Cyber Crisis Management Plan is created with the objective to protect the cyber infrastructure, ICT infrastructure within our organizations, and how we have to react to if there is any cyber attack. What are the policies and procedures and way to react to the cyber attack? So this cyber crisis management plan needs to be implemented by all the organizations and sectors to protect their information infrastructure. Cyber security, the role of CERTIN. The CERTIN stands for Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. Usually all the countries having a national level CERTs, Their role is to respond to the primary role is to respond to the cyber security incidents in their constituency. So for the national cert, constituency is the whole country. For the sectoral cert, like a finance cert, if you talk about power cert, we talk about, they look for their constituency is that specific sector, and they respond to the cyber attacks, cyber attack targeting that particular sector. So for the country India, we have a national cert, that's the cert-IN. So Indian Computer Emergency Response Team is enabled under Section 70B of Information Technology Act, and it's a national nodal agency to serve as a national agency to perform the following function in the area of cyber security. So prime responsibility is to respond to the cyber security incidents, then collection of the data related to the cyber threats, then the roles and responsibilities of the certain are defined in the Act under Section 70B. So cyber security incidents as seen in the country are like web defacement, changing the home page of any website by the malicious actors, attackers, malware propagations, then web application based attack, and as you can see in the list, the difference in various type of attacks are there. Insider attacks are there. There are phishing attempts are there. So those attacks are type of incidents are seen in the country. So in certain the work process, there are several vendors, agencies, international forum reporting, providing information to the CERT-IN, and then CERT-IN is analyzing those reports, those incidents, and then helping the organizations victim to resolve and respond to the cyber security incident or a crisis. So at CERT-IN, we are promoting the best practices such as the how to securing the web server guidelines, antivirus best practices, handling the malware cases is there, platform specific guidelines such as the Linux based, Windows security based, perimeter security guidelines such as on a firewall, intrusion prevention system, intrusion detection system, securing the home computers for the users, parents, businesses, children's, how to be secure online, and security assurance framework that when we are implement doing something, we have to get a confidence that we are doing it right. That's the security assurance framework. CERT-IN is conducting cyber security exercises and participating in cyber security exercises on a regular basis. There are a mock drills, cyber security drills conducted regularly at the national level. There are a tabletop exercises conducted for various organizations and critical sector entities, national exercises, multilateral, international, bilateral exercises with international partners, and sector specific exercises like the for the finance sector, for the power sector, those exercises are conducted. The CERT-IN initiative, there is the cyber security mock drills, national, bilateral and multilateral with international partner, national partner on a regular basis. Skilled and qualified IT security auditors are impaneled by CERT-IN by taking a skill verification test, and CERT-IN is also publishing the computer security guidelines for compliance across government organizations and other sectors. CERT-IN also set up information exchange with sectoral CERT, CISOs, chief information security officers of critical infrastructure organization, ISPs, vendors, and there is an initiative of botnet tracking, malware analysis, and the cleaning and takedown of the command and controls server and the system set up by the attackers. So CERT-IN on regular basis tracking the websites for any defacement, any malicious activity, any intrusions, and CERT-IN also doing the network behavior analysis for distributed denial of service attacks, virus, worm infections. There is a regular vulnerability tracking and the analysis of the those vulnerabilities. So regular training and awareness programs are provided for the different organizations, and those details are available on the CERTIN websites. So CERTIN website is www.cert-in.org.in. So those details are available there. Efforts are being made to promote security, tips for the end users, how to protect and secure their desktops, laptops, mobile phones, USBs, and other devices. There is an initiative launched for the malware cleaning, botnet cleaning, and malware analysis center, that's known as a Cyber Swachhata Kendra. The more details are available at the website. There is an agency which is National Critical Information Infrastructure Protection Center, NCIIPC, and is set up with a vision to facilitate safe, secure, and resilient information infrastructure for critical sectors of the nations. So, mission is to protect the critical, national critical information infrastructure of the country by this agency. There is an information security, education and awareness program initiated by Ministry of Electronics and IT with the objective for building the capacity in the area of information security. So regular training programs are conducted there. More details are available in the slide given there. And so they are creating the more information security professionals so that we can protect the ecosystem, cyber ecosystem of the country. Chief Information Security Officer Guidelines, CISO Guidelines, are released by Ministry of Electronics and IT, and it defines the roles and responsibilities of the Chief Information Security Officers of the organizations, and especially critical sector organization. So it's having those details of the CISO Guidelines, what is expected from the CISOs, is the available at the ministry website, that's the meity.gov.in. There are cybersecurity research and development initiated of Government of India and the ministries, and they invite the various projects from the academia and the researcher to contribute to the cybersecurity by developing the tools, by developing the methodologies and frameworks for securing the cybersecurity ecosystem, for securing the information infrastructure of the country. So cybersecurity research and development details are available at the meity.gov.in, that's I already discussed. Cybersecurity frameworks for banks are released by recently by the Reserve Bank of India in June 2016, and that framework is the for the banks to how they protect their ICT infrastructures and services which are relying on the cyber infrastructure. So this is the empanelment process by the CERTIN, and it's having, as you can see, is having a five-step process. And the first step starts with the document verification, document evaluation of the auditing organizations. Then there is an offline test of those auditors, skill assessment test of those auditors. Then there is a black box online test of auditors. They have to qualify all the steps, and then they have to come for a PIS, personal interaction session, to at the CERTIN to defend their reports. Then there is a background verification, their credential verification. And finally, then if they qualify all these steps, then they are impaneled by CERTIN. So organizations, entity can make use of those vendors, those service provider, for getting their infrastructure audited from the security point of view. For the incident reporting and information exchange, you can write at the incident at the crt-org.in. There is a toll-free number, there is a toll-free fax, there is an incident reporting form available at a website. If some cybersecurity incident happens, so organization report those details at the incident at the cert-org.in. So government is enabling the CERT, CERS, and information Searing and Analysis Center, that's the ISACS. So CSIRT stands for the Computer Security Incident Response Teams, then Computer Emergency Response Teams, and ISACS. So these are the name of the agencies who take care of the cybersecurity incident, who respond to the cybersecurity incidents and improve the cybersecurity of a particular sector or a country. So the level of operations, if you see, there are national level search, there are a sectoral search, there are organization level search also, and there are states government search also. So that's the one of the objective of the government, that to enable the entities, sectors, states and organization to create their own search. So this was about the initiative of the cybersecurity initiatives in India. So in summary, we have discussed in this session about the various government initiatives taken in the cybersecurity. We have discussed about the CSIRT, search bodies and their activities. We have discussed about the information security education and awareness project. We have discussed about the various activities of the CERTing, like the empanelment, incident handling, cyber crisis management plan. So that's for all for this session. Thank you very much.